Hello, this is Julie Harland. Please visit my website, yourmathgal.com, where all my videos are organized by topic. All right, I'm going to do some examples, simplifying basic complex fractions. Now, a complex fraction means you have a basic fraction, so you need to have one large fraction bar, which you see right here, okay? And in the numerator or the denominator, there also has to be another fraction. And by basic, I mean there's no plus or minus signs between them. All right, so this is a basic complex fraction, and we have to remember this fraction bar here means divide. So we can write this as A over B divided by C over D. And then when you divide by a fraction, you multiply by the reciprocal. And then if anything cancels, which you could figure out by factoring, you would cancel. And in this case, you'll get A over AD over BC. So let's look at an example. All right, so we have 14 25ths over 11 30ths. This is a basic complex fraction because it has a single fraction in the numerator and also another fraction in the denominator. So this means 14 25ths divided by 11 30ths, and then we can multiply by the reciprocal. Then we can see if anything could cancel. Let's see, 5 goes into both 25 and 30. So 25 divided by 5 is 5, and 30 divided by 5 is 6. Nothing else cancels. So we have 14 times 6, which is 84 in the numerator, and 5 times 11 is 55 in the denominator, and so there is our answer. All right, our next example has some variables in it, but it's the same idea. We have a fraction divided by another fraction. Now, you don't have to have a fraction in both the numerator and the denominator, but in both of these cases I do. So this means I've got the numerator here, I have a fraction, C, and in the denominator, there happens to be another fraction. So we have 8x cubed over 15y to the 8th divided by 6x to the 6th over 35y to the 10th. And then again, we're going to multiply by the reciprocal. So we have 8x cubed over 15y to the 8th times 35y to the 10th over 6x to the 6th. Remember, it's the reciprocal of the fraction after the division sign. All right, so again, we're going to see if we can cancel anything. Let's see, from 6 and 8, I could divide each of those by 2. So 6 divided by 2 is 3, 8 divided by 2 is 4. And let's see, with the 35 and 15, 5 goes into both of those numbers. So 35 divided by 5 is 7, 15 divided by 5 is 3. And then notice I also have an x cubed in the numerator and an x to the 6th in the denominator. So there are 6 factors of x in the denominator, 3 in the numerator. And remember the rule, you could subtract the exponents. So writing my answer over here, I'm going to write the number part first. I have 4 times 7, which is 28. And 3 times 3 is 9, but then let's check out what's going on with the variables here. So if we look at the x cubed, x to the 6th, there's more x's in the denominator. So we do 6 minus 3, that'll be x cubed. And if we look at the y's, have a y to the 10th in the numerator, y to the 8th. There's more y's in the numerator, so we subtract those exponents, 10 minus 8, and we'll get y squared. And so that's our answer.